Okay, it's the following weekend. It's about the 17th of the 8th, 2014. And this will be around about Evo Sportster Problem number 13. Okay, so I'm pretty sure that I've tested the starter motor operation with the side stand up. That'll be the first test for the weekend, is to put the side stand up and see if the starter motor works. As I say, I'm fairly confident that I've tested it before. It didn't make any difference. However, I could have tested it in relation to some other component of the bike, so I'll test it again. With the push button starter for the starter motor, I'll be trying a few different things. For instance, I'll be bridging these cables here so that the starter button is out of the equation. I'll also be testing the starter motor in relation to the engine stop switch position. I've cleaned up the ground connection before. I'll be doing a better job of that this time, and I'll also be renewing the connectors on the ends of the leads. I don't think you need to do anything fancy like have the clutch pulled in to start the engine. I don't see any sensors anywhere on the clutch lever or the lead or the clutch mechanism. Okay, so we'll see that having the side stand up makes no difference either. So the side stand is up, and I'll switch on the ignition and press the starter button. Yeah, so that's a relief. Not a bit of a relief, I'd say straight out a relief that the side stand doesn't have some type of sensor that if the side stand was down and you tried to start it, it'd make a clicking noise at the starting motor. That would have been very embarrassing if that's what the actual starter problem was, but it's not. I don't know what it could possibly be. At the start of the video I read out my list, and that's simply what I'll be following, is the list. The next job is to make sure that the ground is completely clean and a good connection. I just bring people who've come across this video and not the other videos up to date. So this bike had a misfiring and a bad fire at the spark plug, so it's some type of electrical system fault. At the same time, the starter motor breaks down and doesn't work anymore. Now, whether the two are connected or not, I'm not sure, but this is probably Evo Sportster problem number 13 or 14. So if you want to find the other ones, the best, if you want to follow all of the videos about this problem, you need to go to the channel. Just bring up the search engine and type out Evo Sportster problem and the next number video you want to watch. Okay, so that's the ground connection there. That could possibly explain both the engine backfiring, an ignition problem, and also the starter motor problem, if that was dirty. As I've said before, I've cleaned it before. I've taken it all apart and cleaned it. And now I'll be doing a better job and just trying to rule that completely out of the equation. Okay, so the main cable's off from the battery. I'll just remove the other small one there. So that's what I'm left with, just another nut and a washer. So that there is an actual bolt. I can reach behind the bolt and move it through the frame there. I'm noticing here that the metal here, the contact point, is fairly dirty. Okay, so I'm seeing that the ground connection there is, with the bolt removed, is fairly clean. It doesn't seem to be dirty. So I'll clean it all up, put it all together, and I'll see what I get. Okay, I'm going to set it up differently. Before there was a couple of bolts and washers behind. Now I've got the ground from the battery and that other small cable there, and they're being tightened up straight hard up against the metal of the engine bolt. That nut actually took a while to get on there. It's a slightly cross-threaded nut. It acts a bit like a nylon washer lock nut. But it's all together now, and I'll see what I've got. Yeah, so it's the same story. Okay, so to rule out the push button as the cause of the problem, I've just got a bit of the outside coating away and exposed the wire there, and I'll be bridging that to see if it makes any difference, and we'll see that it also makes no difference. Okay, so the front headlight's got this rubber thing holding it together. I'm just able to peel that out of there, like so. Come around here, there's the back, and there's a few pretty hefty joiners in there. So yeah, you've got your wires coming in the back there. And just leading up to the joins, and then going out on a separate, that higher hole there. Okay, so I've pulled these joins apart. There was a little bit, seemed like a little bit of rust in there. Maybe some water's got in. I've just sprayed that with a bit of oil, but it all seems good. I'll put it back together now. One's got a Phillips head, one's got an old-fashioned slot, so I suppose somebody's lost a screw and put another type in. Okay, so when I turn on the ignition, there's no warning lights coming on the dashboard there. That's just a neutral light, and there's nothing else. The first time I noticed this problem was after I installed this CDI unit box. I installed it and I pushed the push button, and the lights went dead, and took about a minute to reset itself. That's the numbers on the box, 32465-95A, 9644-12-Q. It says all 1200s, all 1200s, that's why I purchased it, REV. The other CDI unit, it's not in place. 32465-95A 9416 1200Q HDI REV- Okay, so it'll do for this weekend. I suppose I've been working on it for a couple of hours. What am I going to do to move forward? Well, my plans are just to trace every single wire and make sure there's no breaks in the wires. Concentrating on the starter unit. I remove the tank and just check every wire.